क्लास 8 टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट चैप्टर नंबर 2 फिजिकल क्वांटिटीज एंड मेजरमेंट नाउ यू ऑल नो व्हाट आर फिजिकल क्वांटिटीज द क्वांटिटीज व्हिच कैन बी मेजर्ड लाइक लेंथ मास टाइम टेम्परेचर ऑल दीज आर कॉल्ड फिजिकल क्वांटिटीज इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट डेंसिटी नाउ व्हाट यू मीन बाय डेंसिटी ऑफ अ बॉडी If you consider a body, each body has a certain mass and a definite volume. If we increase the volume of the body, the mass will also increase. And if you increase the mass of the body, its volume will also increase. Now, it is also found that if we take equal masses of different substances, Suppose we have taken 1 kilogram of cotton and 1 kilogram of lead. So obviously, you will find that the volume occupied by cotton is much more than the same mass of the volume occupied by lead. Why? Because in lead, the molecules are very closely packed. So we can say that lead is much more denser than cotton. So, lead occupies less space. Its volume is less as compared to cotton, although their masses are the same. Similarly, if we take same volume of different substances, like we have taken 1 cubic meter of iron and at the same time 1 cubic meter of wood. So, the mass of iron would be more than the mass of the wood. Again, the same reason. In iron, the molecules are very closely packed. That means iron is denser than that of wood. Thus, to explain that equal volumes of different substances have different masses or equal masses of different substances have different volume, we use the term density. So, the density of a substance is defined as mass per unit volume of the substance. So, what is the formula for density of a substance? Mass of the substance divided by volume of the substance. So, in general, if we represent density by the symbol D, mass by the symbol M and volume by the symbol V, so D becomes M upon V. So, this is density. Now, how will you find the SI unit of this quantity? You know, what is the SI unit of mass? Kilogram. And what is the SI unit of volume? Cubic meter. So, what is the SI unit of density? It is kilogram per cubic meter. You can write it like this also. Kilogram per cubic meter. Okay, now how to find the CGS unit? What is the CGS unit of mass? Gram. And what is the CGS unit of volume? Cubic centimeter. So the unit of density is kilogram per cubic meter and the CGS unit of density is gram per cubic centimeter. Now, I will tell you how to find the relationship between SI unit and CGS unit of density. What is the SI unit of density? Kilogram per cubic meter. Now, 1 kilogram per cubic meter, that means 1 kilogram upon 1 meter. Because here the power of meter is minus and negative. So, it will go in the denominator and it will become positive. So, 1 kilogram upon 1 meter. Now, 1 kilogram is 1000 gram upon and 1 meter is 100 centimeter. So, 1 cubic meter means 100 centimeter whole cube. You have to do whole cube of this because you are converting meter into centimeter. So, 1000 upon 100 into 100 into 100. 3 times you are multiplying 100. And now you will get the unit of CGS, that is gram per cubic centimeter. So, 3 zeros cut with 3 zeros. So, what is left? 1 upon 1000. That means 1 kilogram per cubic meter is 1 upon 1000 gram per cubic centimeter. And what is 1 upon 1000? 10 to the power minus 3. Because this is 1 upon 10 to the power 3, so it will go in the numerator and it will become negative. So 1 kilogram per cubic meter equals to 10 to the power minus 3 gram per cubic centimeter. Children, this is a very important relationship. If you have to convert kilogram per cubic meter to gram per cubic centimeter, you will multiply by 10 to the power minus 3. Similarly, 1 gram per cubic centimeter is 1000 kilogram per cubic meter. And if you have to convert gram per cubic centimeter to kilogram per cubic meter, you will multiply by 1000. Now, how will you determine the density of a regular solid? Now, students, what is a regular solid? Regular solid is that which has a fixed shape. You can easily measure its length, breadth, height by using the correct measuring device. So first of all, first step is that you have to measure the mass of that solid by using a beam balance. Next thing, you have to find the volume of that solid. Now there are some formulae of finding the volume of regular solids. Like volume of cube is given by side cube. Volume of cuboid is length into breadth into height. Volume of sphere is 4 upon 3 pi r cube. Volume of cylinder is pi r square h, where pi is a constant and the value of pi is 3.14. After measuring the volume and all mass you have already measured, now the third step is to put the values in the formula of density. That means density equals to mass upon volume. And you have to take care of the units which you are taking. If the mass is in kilogram, you have to take volume in cubic meter. And if the mass is in gram, then the volume should be in cubic centimeter. So you will measure the density with the correct unit. Either you are using the SI units or you are using the CGS unit. Now children, we use different vessels for measuring the volume of liquids. Some of the vessels have been drawn in your book. Now I am showing you the measuring cylinder. So what is a measuring cylinder? See children, it is made up of a glass or plastic and it is graduated in milliliter with a zero mark at the bottom. Zero is at the bottom. The graduation then increase upwards, like 0, then 10, then 20, then 30. So we have measuring cylinders available of different capacities, such as 50 ml we have, 100 ml we have, 200, etc. And the capacity of the measuring cylinder is marked on it, that how many milliliters of liquid it can contain, that is marked on the measuring cylinder. Now children, these are measuring beakers. See, now the volume, the capacity of the beakers is marked at the top. Like here it is written 100 ml. That means this vessel can contain 100 milliliter of the liquid which is filled into it. So these are made up of glass or plastic or metals also, like aluminium. And the capacity of the measuring beaker is marked on it. You must have seen these beakers with your milkmen. Children, this is Eureka can which is used in laboratories. It is also made up of glass or metal and it has a side opening. And this side opening is called spout. Now it can contain liquid up to the mouth of this spout, up to this level. If any excessive liquid is there, it will flow through this spout. Next is the determination of density of an irregular solid. Suppose I give you a stone and I tell you to measure the density of that stone. So you can find the mass of the stone easily by using a common beam balance. But how will you find the volume of the stone? Can you measure its length, breadth, height? Can you measure the volume? No, it is not possible because it is an irregular shaped body. So this method, displacement method, this is called, and this you will use to find the volume of an irregularly shaped body. You will take a measuring cylinder and you will fill water up to a certain level. So let this be V1 ml. Here the volume is up to the mark of 50 ml. So what is the original volume of water? 50 ml. Now you tie that stone with the string or a thread and you immerse it in the measuring cylinder, in this cylinder only. Now obviously the stone will take some place and the volume, the level of the water will increase. So let the new level be V2. Here it is 70 ml. So what is the volume of stone? V2 minus V1. Suppose 70 minus 50, here it is 20 milliliters. So you will get the volume of the stone. And mass you have already measured with your beam balance. So density is given by mass upon volume. So you will get the density of this solid. Now children, this is a density bottle. Now a density bottle is a specially designed bottle used to store a fixed amount of liquid in it, and the capacity is generally marked on it. Like this is 50 ml density bottle, so it can store 50 ml of liquid in it if it is filled up to the brim. It has a small, it is a small glass bottle having a glass topper. There is a glass topper at its neck. The bottle can store a fixed amount of liquid. Now the stopper also has a small hole in it. When the bottle is filled with the liquid and the stopper is inserted, the excess liquid rises above through the hole and it is drained out. Thus the bottle always contains the same volume of the liquid as it is marked on it. So generally we have 50 ml or 25 ml of density bottles. Now children, one very important thing, the density of water is equals to 1 gram per cubic centimeter. So the mass in gram, because the density we are taking in gram per cubic centimeter, the mass in gram of water used to fill this bottle will give you the volume of this bottle. The mass of the water filled in this will give you the volume of this bottle. Nowadays it is not named as specific gravity bottle. Now children, you have to read the chapter yourself till the topic is done, and you also start doing the objective questions given in your book. You can mark the objective questions in the book only because there is a lot of space given in the book. Okay children, thank you.